Let's do a problem involving the intermediate value theorem. The directions here say to use the intermediate value theorem, if possible, to determine if the following functions have any roots in the given interval. So remember, a root of a function simply means a place where the function crosses the x-axis. So that would be a point where the function f of x equals 0. Okay, so let's look at number 1. So in number 1, the function that we're given is a rational function, f of x equals x plus 1 over x squared minus 4, and the interval we're considering is from 0 to 5. Now, just from the very beginning, we need to decide if the intermediate value theorem even applies. Now, for the intermediate value theorem to apply, the function must be continuous over the interval that we're looking at. Now, since this is a rational function, I'm automatically a little suspicious because I know that rational functions can be discontinuous wherever their denominator equals 0. So to take a closer look, let's factor this rational function as much as we can. So f of x equals x plus 1 on top. Now on the bottom I have the difference of squares, so I can factor that into x plus 2 and x minus 2. Okay, so what do I see here? I see that the denominator is going to be 0 whenever x equals negative 2 or x equals positive 2. So the function is not continuous on the interval from 0 to 5. That means the intermediate value theorem does not apply at all. We can't use it to answer this question. Since the function is not continuous, we really don't know what's going on between 0 and 5. And so we can't guarantee that there's a root in there. So whenever you're answering these questions about intermediate value theorem, you always want to be very careful about stating your logic and why or why not the theorem applies. So in this case, I'm just going to say the intermediate value theorem, so often that's abbreviated IVT, does not apply in this case because f of x is not continuous on 0 to 5. And that would be my answer in this case. Okay, let's do another example. I have a number 2 below. Same directions. We want to use the intermediate value theorem if possible to determine if the function has any roots on the given interval. Okay, so now we've got g of x, and it's a nice polynomial. So I've got g of x equals x to the fourth plus 3x squared minus 7x plus 1. And I'm looking at the interval from 0 to 1. Okay, so right off the bat, I know that this function is continuous because it's a polynomial. So I don't have to worry about that part of the intermediate value theorem. So the next thing I want to do is I want to check the endpoints of the interval. So I want to see what is g of 0 and what is g of 1. Okay, so let's calculate those. So g of 0, I'm simply plugging in 0 to this function. So 0 to the 4th plus 3, 0 squared minus 7 times 0 plus 1 just equals 1. If I plug in 1, let's see, I've got 1 to the 4th plus 3 times 1 squared minus 7 times 1 plus 1. So let's see, that's 1 plus 3 minus 7 plus 1. So let's see, that's 4 minus 7, so that's negative 3 plus 1, so that gives me negative 2. Okay, so g of 0 is 1, and g of 1 is negative 2. So by the intermediate value theorem, can I say that there's a root in the given interval? Let me show you something on a graph. I'm not going to graph the whole function, but I just want to show you something very quickly. So I've determined that g of 0 is 1. Okay, so when x equals 0, the function value is 1. And I've determined that g of 1 is negative 2. So I know my function is continuous between these two points, so then it must be, just by looking at this graph intuitively, that there's a root in between there, right? If it's continuous, it must cross the axis. And that's exactly what the intermediate value theorem tells us. So we know that there's a root, but let's actually write out our answer in the form that you might on an exam. So this is what I would write. Since g of x is continuous on the interval 0 to 1, and 0 is a number between 1 and negative 2, right? Because I'm looking for places where the function value equals 0, and I checked my endpoints and they were 1 and negative 2. So since 0 is between 1 and negative 2, then I know that there is at least one root in 0 to 1. Okay, so this would be good phrasing for an exam. It explains the logic. It shows that you understand the theorem, why it applies, and it shows that you know the result of the theorem.